In these episodes, we've been talking about how God establishes our steps, according to Psalm 37. In this episode, we're going to talk about how in every step God is involved. We can trust His power. Providence means that God is not only interested in what we do and instructive about what we do, but He has His hand on what we do. Throughout Psalm 37 is the theme of land. The idea of land basically comes down to this. This is God's world. We are just paying rent. Right now, there are godly and ungodly people living on God's land. Everyone gets an opportunity, and God's keeping record of what we do with our opportunity. Currently, it seems as if the wicked prosper, but suddenly a day will come when everything changes. In His providence, God takes what is wrong and makes it right. There's a sense of reversal throughout the passage. In verse 14, the wicked draw the sword and the bow against the poor and needy. In the beginning of verse 10, the wicked seem to have an established place in which they prosper. Yet by the end of the verse, they vanish. When God brings His righteous judgment, the wicked will not survive. Psalm 37:2 says, "For they will soon fade like the grass and wither like the green herb." The Lord is powerful. At some point, the opportunity that the wicked have to repent in the land will draw to a close. You may even be someone who doesn't think it's important to have your steps established by the Lord. You feel as if you're doing well just as you are. Everything you touch prospers and comes up green. And that may be true for now, but remember, summer doesn't last forever. For the godly who walk with the Lord, the threat of God's judgment is ominous. But the godly are comforted because they'll be saved in judgment rather than destroyed by it. Psalm 37:17 says, "For the arms of the wicked shall be broken, but the Lord upholds the righteous." In fact, the situation for the godly will change just as drastically as it does for the ungodly in the judgment. The godly who live like strangers in the land suddenly inherit the land. Psalm 37:9-11. The Lord is powerful and involved. He knows those who are His, and He will, in His providence, establish their steps so that they will eventually inherit the land. The hope that God's providential involvement brings applies not only to the future. We are also the beneficiaries in the present. In verses 23 through 25, David says, "The steps of a man are established by the Lord when he delights in his way. Though he fall, he shall not be cast headlong. For the Lord upholds his hand. I've been young, and now I am old, yet I have not seen the righteous forsaken or his children begging for bread." While reflecting on an experience in battle, David praises the Lord. "You gave a wide place for my steps under me, and my feet did not slip." 2 Samuel 22:37. In the chaos of the battlefield, the Lord was powerfully involved in the details of David's walk as a warrior. Even the placement of David's feet in the fight was a detail God didn't overlook. Psalm 18:1-2 reads, "I love you, O Lord, with my strength. The Lord is my rock and my fortress, my deliverer, my God, my rock in whom I take refuge, my shield and the horn of my salvation, my stronghold." According to the prescript on the psalm, David penned it on the day when he experienced rescue from his enemies, particularly Saul. No doubt in the heat of the moment, for those who trust in the Lord, the application of God acting as our strength and our refuge becomes apparent. Our walk with Him deepens in the experience of the trial. Yet I wonder how often God acts as my shield and I walk away unaware. I once served with a fellow pastor on our staff who oversaw our student ministries. His father-in-law held a very important position. He was the director of Homeland Security for the state of Georgia. His title probably made the faceplate on his desk weigh about 12 pounds. I'm sure if you were to ask him, "How was your day?" there's really only a certain percentage of that answer that you'd like to know. For the percentage left unanswered, fill your imagination with shows like The Blacklist, NCIS, 24, and a smattering of other crime shows in which we are exposed to the terrorist underworld for 60 minutes with commercial interruption. The difference in our day and his day is that we can safely turn off the television and it all goes away. He can't. When something blows up, you'll hear about the Homeland Security Office. But I wonder how many things haven't blown up, and you had no idea that Homeland Security was even there. There's so much going on in the world that I don't want to know, because I like to sleep. While I sleep peacefully, I wonder how great is God's grace as our shield. How often does He protect me, and I am unaware? Psalm 18:2 reminds me that He is there when I need Him as my shield, my rock, my strength, my fortress, my deliverer. Psalm 18:2 reminds me that He's there even when I'm unaware of how desperately I need Him. How many things in my life were so close to blowing up, and I walked away from my shield, ungrateful and unaware that He was there? Because God is powerfully involved, He is able not only to protect, but to change even the most dire of situations. Knowing this motivates our prayer life. We don't trust luck. We don't chalk it up to fate. We don't believe in the false ideological idol of deism. We pray to a very real God who has His hand on every situation. Listen to what David says in Psalm 40, verses 1 through 4. I waited patiently for the Lord. He inclined to me and heard my cry. He drew me up from the pit of destruction out of the miry bog. He set my feet upon a rock, making my steps secure. He put a new song in my mouth, a song of praise to our God. Many will see and fear and put their trust in the Lord. Blessed is the man who makes the Lord his trust, who does not turn to the proud, to those who go astray after a lie. The phrase used in Psalm 37:11, "the meek shall inherit the land," was quoted by Jesus in Matthew 5:5. Ultimately, the interest, instruction, and involvement we find in the Lord's providence is fulfilled in God's Son. All that the Lord has determined to do will be accomplished by Jesus. Currently, He's gathering a people whose steps are established by the Lord and who will inherit the land with Him. They are able to navigate a difficult world as it is now because they serve a God who is interested. They take steps that are instructed. They're helped by the hand of a mighty God who's always involved. Though one may stumble along the way, he shall not be cast headlong, for the Lord upholds his hand. Psalm 37:24. Even his missteps don't become ultimate mistakes. Why? The steps of those who desire to go further are established by the Lord. This means that those who walk with Him have a good God who is providentially interested. The godly trust His character. We have a good God who is providentially instructive. The godly trust His word. We have a good God who is providentially involved. The godly trust His power. Thank you for joining me for today's episode of A Walk Through the Summer.